Hello, my loves. Happy Monday. Welcome back to the Slay Girl Slay podcast. Hoping all of your weeks are off to a great start. I hope everyone had a beautiful weekend. I am working on some really, really fun stuff for you guys that I can't reveal just yet, but all my time and energy is going into everything Slay Girl Slay these days. And I'm eating, sleeping, breathing Slay Girl Slay. And I'm excited for all of you to see what we have in store for you. If this is your first time tuning into us, my name is Ashley. Most people just call me Ash, and I am your host and fearless leader of the Slay Girl Slay movement. Welcome to our circle. So glad that you found us and hoping you enjoy this time together as much as I do. We're just going to jump right in today as we were talking about the weekend earlier and how every ounce of my energy and just being has been going into Slay Girl Slay and the amazing things we have coming up. This weekend, I got served a large slice of humble pie, y'all. Last week, I was in a great mood and I felt like I was on top of my work. I was getting stuff done. I was slaying and things have just been flourishing and going my way. I mean, I'm saying good morning to everyone as I'm walking outside in LA and I'm taking the time to hold doors open for people, which is what I should be always doing, right? But I mean, I'm laying it on thick because no one can touch this mood I'm in, right? False. Let me just come right out and say it like this. When you place your expectations into people and things, your feelings will get hurt. Straight like that. If you are putting an expectation on something or someone to deliver back to you what you need or whatever it is that you're asking for, you are essentially doing yourself a major disservice. And I'll tell you why in a sec. I've been working on this project, and when I start something or engage with something or someone, naturally, I am putting the expectation in that thing or person that I will get back whatever it is I'm pouring into it. So in my mind, and this is just how my mind thinks, if I'm treating someone a certain way, let's say a friend or a boyfriend or whomever, if I'm giving them high quality ash, I'm expecting high quality friend or high quality boyfriend right back. If I'm working with someone for work and I'm giving them high quality work ethic or spending my high quality dollars, let's just put it like that, I'm expecting high quality product in return. Fortunately, that only happens in a perfect world, and unfortunately, neither you or I reside in that perfect world. And when those expectations are not met, we are left with our lips poking out and mad, and we're sad and ready to fight somebody. Because how dare this person or this thing not give back to us what we gave to them? And here's the thing with expectations. Expectations trigger faith. They trigger our faith. And when we are expecting something to work out or for someone to reciprocate what we give to them, we are putting our faith into them to deliver in a way that they may not know how to deliver. We're putting our faith into something to work out that maybe shouldn't even be working out the way we think it should to begin with. You feel me? And I understand that, you know, that may be a bit harsh, and essentially, you should expect your friends to treat you how you treat them. You should expect whatever it is you're working on to be perfect and to thrive and to flourish the way that you want it to. But the moment it does not go the way we want it to go, or that person does not act the way we expect them to act, we get messed up because it's not what we were expecting, and our faith was telling us that it would be how we wanted it to be and it would go the way we wanted it to go. But this is a very, very hard lesson I've had to learn and still learning literally to this very day that it will never go the way you want it to. People, work, business, never. We have carved out these perfect roadmaps to these destinations we want to get to, but excluding out all the bumps in the road on the way there, because no one wants to create struggle for themselves. No one wants to come across issues that they may have to solve or worry about, because we're all just trying to get there, and rightfully so, right? So, you know, this weekend, I'm upset and I have a real attitude. My attitude is affecting my work. And I met up with my photographer. I should call her a photographer friend. And we're shooting. And in the middle of the shoot, I'm just telling her why I got so upset this weekend. And literally the words come out of my mouth. I was not expecting this to happen. I was not expecting it to go this way. And she fully understood where I was coming from, but made a great point and was just like, it had to happen so you could learn something from it. It's out of your control. And she's totally right. You know, it's not always going to be peaches and rainbows. And y'all already know that. And we're all human, and expecting something from someone or putting your faith into your job or the projects you work on or your mentors or whomever is a natural thing, and we all do it. And getting our feelings hurt is natural as well, but it's not about having a pity party like I was doing and sitting in it. It's the lesson we take from it. We can get very much wrapped up into ourselves and forget that the only person, place, or thing we should put our expectations in is yourself and God alone. And y'all know I am no pastor, and the only thing I can do is share with you my experience. And in my experience, I know that there has never been a time where God has failed me or let me down or disappointed me. Never. Now, I'm not saying my feelings haven't gotten hurt a time or two, because what I was seeking from him was not for me, and only he knew the plans that he had for me. But I do know that when I start placing my faith in other people or things, that's when I get disappointed. That's when I get upset and angry, and I stop holding the door for people because I'm walking around with this chip on my shoulder and I got an attitude because things aren't going my way. But only when I put my expectations in God and start saying, you know what, God, you do this. You know what, God, I have no control over this situation. You handle it. God, I really want this to happen in my life, but only if it's your will, you do this. That's when I have my best days, y'all. That's when I feel like I come out on top. When I used to deal with F-boys, used to, because the way my life and goals are set up, I don't have time anymore. But when I used to deal with guys like that, and when things didn't work out, I'd be all sad and upset and depressed, and deep down, I'd know in my heart they weren't for me, and I'd pray to God and say, you know what? I clearly must be blind, Lord, because I thought this was the one for me, but he's clearly not, and I desire your will above mine, so whatever you have for me, put me in the position to receive that. And I know y'all are like, Ash, you have to have expectations of people or places or things. You just have to. But the reality is, boo, you really don't. And I mean that in the nicest way possible. Just because you have a mom doesn't mean you should be placing your expectations into her to be a mom to you and perform mom things for you. Just because you have a dad doesn't mean you should expect him to take care of you for the rest of your life. Same for any other family members or friends you have. Just because you have a job does not mean you should expect that they will keep you as an employee forever and not fire you, even if you are doing a good job. Do y'all hear me though? You cannot put your faith into another human being who is going through their own battles and struggles and dealing with their own issues and in their own seasons. You cannot put your faith into a job, a business, or whatever materialistic project that you're working on. Your faith has to go through God and God alone, because he knows your heart and he knows your desires. And if you desire that business, if you desire that type of relationship, you have to go through him first, and all things shall be added unto you. I am learning to meet people where they are with my expectations. I allow their actions to set my expectations of them, which is merely no true expectation at all, if I'm being honest. If someone is consistently in and out of my life or always drops the ball with something, always disappoints me in some way, I relinquish that expectation I have of them and meet them where they are. I make a mental note that this is where this person is right now, and this is what this person did, and it is not a reflection of who I am, but just where they are. And then I keep it pushing. And when or if it happens where I find myself seeking something out of them again in the future, I remember that mental note that I made and know that based on their previous actions, this is where they are right now. And in order to save my feelings from getting hurt and be respectful to them at the same time as a person, I have no expectations of them, but to just be as they have always been until they show me otherwise. As women, I think that we can really change the game if we start checking our expectations at the door. We will spend a lot less time worrying and being confused and trying to figure it out if we already know what our expectations are of the people and things we choose to work with in our lives, both personal and professional. When you find yourself expecting things to go a certain way, flip it around and put the expectations on yourself. Say, I expect myself to go about this situation next time in this way. I expect myself to handle this job this way from now on. I expect myself to boss up and go after my dreams and goals the way I know I was born to do. And I expect God and God alone to see me through. All right, you guys, that wraps us up for this week. I would much appreciate it if you guys would leave a comment in the comment section with your thoughts on the Slay Girl Slay podcast, and even more if you would subscribe. Send me an email with any topics or feedback on today's podcast, and you can always find us on Instagram and Facebook at Slay Girl Slay, or come visit us on our website at www.slaygirlslay.com. Until next week, we will chat soon. Peace.